Assalamu alaikum everybody and a very warm welcome to day 22 in my Somali Diary. For those of you who haven't been here before, go back and watch the previous 21 episodes. But essentially what this series is me talking about the Somali that I'm picking up along the way. Obviously my wife is Somali and I'm making kind of a conscious effort to do Somali courses, read Somali books and stuff like that. So what are we talking about today? So we're talking about one very specific word in Somali. And it is the word la'an. La'an, because I've seen it used in kind of about in like three different ways just this week, so I thought it'd be worth doing a little video about it for you guys. So la'an kind of means lacking in something, but I'll give you a few examples just to build a bit more context around it, inshallah. So one example would be I saw on somebody's Instagram story recently them say hurdo la'an, hurdo la'an. So hurdo means sleep, right? So hurdo la'an, it means like lack of sleep. You know, like the guy just hadn't slept for ages or something. He was really tired. So, hurdo la'an. And that was just all he put in there. So, and then maybe that just means like sleep deprived. You know, that just is an expression. Hurdo la'an means sleep deprived is what it seems like. Another one is there's a really famous expression. We kind of have this proverb in English too, which is, it's kind of the Somali equivalent of a woman makes a house a home. It's kind of like that. And in Somali, it's haween la'an wa hoy la'an. Haween la'an wa hoy la'an. So it's like lacking a woman is lacking a home. It's kind of like that. So we have that same expression in English, a woman makes a house a home. So those are kind of three examples actually of using the word la'an. And the last one I wanted to mention is the word la'ag la'an. La'ag la'an. And that actually leads me on to a nice point I wanted to end this video on actually. So la'ag la'an. So la'ag, if you watched the previous video, you'll know. Let me move to a different hand because my arm's aching now. I need my tripod. So if you watched the previous video, you know that the word la'ag means money. But la'ag la'an means that something's free. You know, if there's, you know that there's no need, it's moneyless, right? It's lacking a price. La'ag la'an. So that's a nice one for you to know as well. Because I remember I released an Arabic course ages ago and I remember people asking me if it was la'ag la'an. That particular one was not la'ag la'an, but I do have an Arabic course which is la'ag la'an for you guys who are interested in it. Obviously, the month of Ramadan is creeping up on us again. It's only a few months away now, subhanAllah. And if you want to brush up on your Arabic, now is a really good time to start. And if you need something to kind of kickstart you, then I have a free Arabic course. And there's a really obvious way to get to it. It's called freearabiccourse.com. So go to freearabiccourse.com and I have this little free course on there, which is kind of a 6-lesson free course. And there's one very clear objective of the course. It's to read the first page of the story of Yusuf, alayhi salam. And I kind of created that course after my son Yusuf was born. It's kind of a bit of a tribute to him. But yeah, there's a free course, 100% free for you guys to have. There's a little free workbooklet that you get with it too. So if you want to kind of kickstart your Arabic a little bit and prepare well for the month of Ramadan, because most people leave it way too late. Most people are like 3 days away from Ramadan. I'll need to learn Arabic, but it would make much more sense to, to say 3 months away from Ramadan. Then you can actually make some progress, inshallah. So go and check that out. And that course is 100%. La'ag la'an. If you enjoyed this video, and I really hope you did, don't forget to like and share it, and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Ad bad gumahad santahin dawa shadina fadlan like share your subscribe daha. Assalamu alaikum. Yonabad giliyu.